going on, guys? Fatty Mancy here. So what we're gonna learn to do is two separate exercises. They both go hand in hand, so that's why we're gonna just learn it all in one video. The first is gonna be a step up, okay? A proper step up while holding the dumbbell. So when we're doing an exercise like this, the repetition range is gonna be a little bit more. So we wanna pick a weight that's heavy enough to challenge us, but not heavy enough where we're not gonna be able to complete our reps. When we're doing this, we wanna begin at somewhere around a 12-inch platform. That's what I have here. As we're doing this, the first thing we wanna make sure that we're doing is that our knees are not moving forward ahead of our toes, okay? What that does is, first of all, that gives us a great quad workout, but it's also gonna ruin our knees in the meantime, okay? So we wanna make sure that we're keeping our heels on the floor, and we wanna try and keep our shin as vertical as possible. As we're doing this, you're gonna see me step up and bring my opposite leg forward to a 90 degree angle. So let me do a repetition really quick. And we wanna hold that for a second. We wanna squeeze the glute that our leg is on while we're doing this exercise. Common mistake while we're doing this is our knee caves in. So stay where you're at. We wanna make sure while we're doing this that our knee stays in line with the outside of our toes. You can think of external hip rotation, keeping our hips out. In the same breath, we wanna keep our hips out and make sure that our feet stay firmly planted on the ground. So if we are coming out and we're doing that number, you'll see that I'm not gonna be able to stay stable. Conversely, we wanna make sure that our knee does not come in as we're doing this and come out, because that's gonna give us some knee problems as well. As we're doing this, we're going to alternate legs while we're doing the workout. So if I give you a total of 12 repetitions, it's going to be 6 on each leg. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's the speed I want you doing it at. Any faster, you're using muscle instead of form and technique. Front view of what it's gonna look like, keep in line with outside my toes. Now the progression from this, once we get accustomed to this, after a week or two, is we're gonna do a single leg step up to a curl to an overhead press, okay? So as we're doing this, it's gonna be really important that we stay tight in our core, diaphragmatic breathing in. Breathing into our stomach, you wanna think of like you're filling up a water balloon, okay? So the inhale and all the air is going into our stomach. Here, stepping up, curl, bring it down. That's one repetition. Making sure that we're staying tight in our core and not locking our knees while we're stepping up. That way, all the pressure is going through our glutes, our hamstrings, our core, and that's gonna keep us stable to do the curl to the press. A common mistake while we're doing the curl to the overhead press is swinging. In turn, we're gonna lose our balance. So, stepping up, swinging. See how my back starts arching? We don't wanna do that. We wanna make sure the weight is controlled. That's why we choose a weight that's light enough that we're gonna do, you know, a minimum of 12 repetitions. As we're gonna be doing the overhead press, we wanna make sure the dumbbells dissect our body. Okay. So we don't wanna go too far back, too far forward. Dumbbells should be dissecting our body. So that's how we do a dumbbell step up and a dumbbell step up curl to overhead press. See you on the next video.